hear my heart, oh, hear my heart, it's satisfied within your presence, and I see beneath the shadow. That better is one day in your courts, one day in your house. Better is one day in your courts. Oh, better is one day in your courts, one day in your house. Better is one day in your courts. Oh, better, better. One day in your house. closer to your presence, God.
Oh, For you are holy, holy. Are you Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy, worthy of it all. Worthy, worthy of it all. Worthy, worthy of it all. There's glory all around, glory all around. There's glory all around, glory all around. There's glory all around, glory all around.
Yes, Lord, glory all around.
There's glory all around, glory all around. Glory all around, glory all around. There's glory all around, glory all around.
Are the prayers of the saints, and they sang a new song. You are worthy. You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you were slaughtered and you purchased people for God by your blood from every tribe and language and people and nation. You have made them a kingdom of priests to our God, and they will reign on the earth. And they sang a new song, singing, you are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you were slaughtered and you purchased your people for God by your blood. You are worthy, Jesus. You are worthy, Holy Spirit. As we sing, you're worthy. Would you let that go deep, that Jesus is worthy because he was slaughtered and he purchased us by his own blood. Every tribe and language, every people and nation. And you have made us a kingdom of those who can stand before you this afternoon. Who can stand before you. Who can stand in your glory. Who can stand in your presence. You say that those who stand in your presence will reign in the earth. We say that you were worthy. And they sang with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb who was slaughtered to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessings. And I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea sing a new song, blessing and honor and glory and power be to the one who's worthy, who's seated on the throne, and to the Lamb forever and ever. You are worthy.
Offer up our praise and affection. We cry, holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Is the Lamb.
Before there was an eye.
don't shine like who you are all my life, transfixed upon your heart. The brilliance of the stars, they don't shine like who you are all my life, transfixed upon your heart. Every galaxy formed in every raging sea that storms, all cries out to the Lord of all. Oh, in every galaxy you formed, in every raging sea that storms, they all cry out to the Lord of all. The brilliance of the stars, all for now to the Lord.
and sustainer and creator of all that's lovely and pure and good and beautiful. We confess today the truth that you shine above them all, that the most stunning places in creation, the most beautiful faces, the most rich moments in our memory are mere shadows, just faint reflections of the all-surpassing beauty that you and you alone contain. You alone are perfect in holiness. You alone look to you now, beautiful one. We look to you and we release all the trappings of life, all the cares of the world, all the longings of the flesh, all the lesser desires, and with the heart cry of our forefathers, we ask you, show us your glory. Let us see again your beauty, Lord. This all-surpassing beauty, the weight of your goodness, the expression of your wholeness, your completeness. In your light, we see light. Would you open our eyes to behold what was shown in part to Moses? You said we have now in the fullness, shining in the face of Christ within our own hearts. So we ask you, show us your glory. We want to see his face, to be transfixed, to be caught up, to be reminded of what matters, to be renewed in fresh vision and faith, to see with our eyes the very face. That was from everlasting, the uncreated one. We long to see you today. To get a glimpse, another glimpse of the face that we will stare at and marvel at and weep over and rejoice over for eternity. This face that we now stand before. Open our eyes. Oh, surrender. Whoa. Is so costly when we lose sight of what's superior. But when we see you, Lord, we cannot open our hands and hearts to offer you everything, because you alone satisfy. You alone, you alone. So with the cry of Moses and in the desire of David, we say, show us, to behold your beauty, to see your glory.
Ask for for blessing and you gave your presence. Oh, oh, yeah. We asked for glory and you gave your presence. My eyes to caught up in wonder who you are. All of the stars fall, kingdoms bow your feet. Glory to glory. Closer and closer, heaven to earth, moving from glory to glory. And I lift my eyes into heaven's throne. I'm caught up in wonder who you kingdoms bow at your feet. Given the name above all names. given the name above all names. The ends of the stars, they don't shine like who you are. All my life transfixed upon your heart. Oh, every galaxy you formed, every rage and sea the storms, all cry out to the Lord of all. Yeah, the brilliance of the stars, they don't shine like who you are. All my life transfixed upon your heart. In every galaxy you form, every rage and sea that storms, all cry out to the Lord of all.
Singing this. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For everything was created by him in heaven and on earth, the visible and the invisible. Whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, all things have been created through him and for him. He is before all things, and by him all things hold together. He is also the head of the body of the church. He is the beginning. He is the firstborn from the dead, so that he might come to have first place in everything. For God the Father was pleased to have him as all, to have all his fullness dwell in him, and through him to reconcile everything to himself, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through the blood shed on the cross. Once you were alienated and hostile in your minds, expressed in your evil actions, but now he has reconciled you by his physical body through his death to present you as holy and faultless and blameless before him. Holy and faultless and blameless before him. Jesus, you are the answer to Moses' cry, show me your glory. You are the answer to David's cry, one thing have I desired. And the Father answered, him, Jesus, the Lamb, is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of the dead. So we look up to the image of the invisible. It's not, you're not someone we can't see today. You're not someone that we cannot look upon, but you're the very thing that the Father calls us to look upon. So God, we lift our eyes and we look at Christ Jesus. We look at our great high priest. We look at our big brother today. We look at the one who sent the Spirit. We gaze on the one who gave his body. We gaze on the one who spilled his blood. You call him beautiful. You say that he is lovely. And so God, with everything within us, with all of our hearts, we fix our eyes this afternoon on the image of the invisible God, the Son who looks like the Father, the one who's inside the Father, the one whom the Father is inside. We look on the one who is one. We look on the one who is one. We look on the one who is one. You are not a mystery that cannot be seen. You are not a mystery that cannot be heard. You are not a mystery that the world cannot know. So we look on you. We look on you. The stars are beautiful, but we can look at you now. The sky is glorious, but we can look at you now. Oh God, your miracles are great, but we can look on you now. So we fix our eyes. No matter how beautiful, creation testifies beautifully of you, but we can look on you. The image of the invisible, the image of the invisible. We lift our eyes today. We lift our eyes today, Abba. We lift our eyes. We do you the honor of lifting our eyes to Christ Jesus. Come on, we lift our eyes to Christ Jesus. How can we but respond to you?
Oh, you are holy. Who are you? Father to the fatherless, along to the orphan, showing mercy and compassion.
Someone that even when Moses cried out, "Show me your glory," and he got hidden in the cleft of the rock, and the Father covered him with his hand and he said, "I'll let my goodness pass before you," but the goodness was the proclamation of his name, the Lord God, compassionate and gracious, full of loving kindness and truth, forgiving iniquity and sin. It was the proclamation of the character of his Son through the Father's mouth. That was the goodness that passed before Moses. And what he saw in part, we now have received in full. That the glory of God is not some thing to seek. It is someone to release, someone to reflect that as sons and daughters of God, we're positioned with authority to say, let there be light in places where the sun's face is hidden, where his character is polluted, where his presence seems to be absent, that we get in the authority of belonging to him, get to release and declare glory into those places, glory into the darkness, glory into the places of oppression, glory into what seems devoid of hope and beauty, to speak Christ into those places. Yeah. Ava, why don't you share what you were saying?
Yes, keep going. So if you guys would all stand up, we're gonna do something super fun. We're gonna release this. So if you've been kind of like soaking, I'm glad you soaked it all in. Now we get to do something real fun, okay? So just like Kevin was praying, glory as a person, we're gonna do two things. The first thing we're gonna do is, I just kind of all seen us, if there's someone standing next to you, will you turn and look at that person? Don't be weird, just turn and look at them really fast. And I heard the Lord say, you wanna see glory? You wanna see the person? There's a scripture that says, God, no man has seen God but the Son. But he can be seen in each one of us. So when you look at your neighbor and say, wow, I see the glory of God.
I see the glory of God.
I see the glory of God. I see the person of Jesus.
I see the person of Jesus.
All right. So what we're going to do now, we're going to pray. I want you, the person that you're looking at, we're going to say a prayer. I want you to release the glory, the person of Jesus, into their life, and they're going to release it into yours. And then we're going to line up, and I want you to declare, Lord, release your glory into, or the person of Jesus into, and you can do it in a nation, you can do it into an organization, you can do it into a family member, but we want to release the person of Jesus, the glory of God, the revelation of that, into an area where, like Kevin said, it may not be easily seen, amen? This is the fun part, y'all. So here we go. I'm gonna pray with Kevin, and you guys pray with each other, and they're gonna sing, and I'm gonna tell you what we'll do next, okay? All right. Yeah, Jesus, we thank you that you are the glory of God. You are the image of the invisible God, that you're not just a random atmosphere that falls on us. You're not just gold dust. You're not just strange things that might happen that we've never seen. But Jesus, you're the glory. You're a person.
like him. Releasing hope and healing. Now we are walking Edens, made to look just like him. Releasing hope and healing all around. Now we are walking Edens, made to look just like him. Releasing hope and healing all around. Now we are walking in Eden.
Yes, Lord. We just take on this
just like
that we are all made
releasing hope
to look just like you. Releasing
around.
Hope and healing.
We release the glory in this place. A royal priest is found in Jesus' name. Release glory. We release glory. Now we are walking.
right, guys. Now that you know that you're a priesthood and you can release hope, you can release healing and reconciliation, anything that Jesus released, you can release. So we're going to do a thing. I'll be right here. And it's super simple. If you want to pray a prayer, pray a prayer. But I want you to declare something. I want you to say, Lord, release your glory to... So if you want to pray for Ukraine, God, release your glory in Ukraine. God, release your glory in Gen Z. I want you to just release something because we have so much gift in us, right? Jesus is a really big gift. Who he is a really big gift. And so I'm going to tell all of you right now that you have so many gifts on you right now. And I want you to give them away in intercession. I want you to give them away. I want you to try to give away as much of Jesus, and I want you to go for the nations. He says, ask for them and I'll give them to you. I want you to go for the government. He says, ask and I'll give it to you. But right now, you're stacked with gifts. You're stacked with glory right now. And so I want you to come up and declare anything. Family members, God, release your glory here. So I'm gonna open up the mic.
Moscow, Russia. I pray that you would raise up sons and daughters, warriors, fighters in the spirit, God, people that are marked with the spirit of prayer and intercession, God. Send them your light and your truth. Let them lead them. Let them guide them to your holy mountain, to the place where you dwell, God. I pray that you would release a spirit of wisdom and a revelation that would make you known to them, God. That you would enlighten the eyes of their hearts to see what is the glory of your Son, God. That they would know you, that they would see you, that they would taste and see that you're good, Lord. That they would hunger and thirst for you and you alone, Lord. In Jesus' name.
I want to release glory in two aspects. First one, high schools in America. So Jesus, I release the glory by the blood of the Lamb in high schools in America. May the sounds of heaven be touching every single student's heart. Jesus, may you give us, our generation, strategies, wisdom, discernment of who you are to bless their hearts, Jesus. Thank you for who you are, for Gen Z in high schools and middle schools as well, Jesus, we say thank you. And I also want to release glory to nations, specific for Brazil. Jesus, eu oro para que você venha trazer a glória do Senhor para o Brasil, para as nações. It's your Brazil and for nations in Latin America. Jesus, thank you for the fire. Obrigado pelo fogo, Jesus. Thank you for the fire. Thank you for something pure that you're bringing to Brazil. Obrigado, Jesus, por algo puro que o Senhor está trazendo para o Brasil, Jesus. Algo na adoração, something for the worship. I just declare something pure and honest and clean that is coming straight up from heaven to Brazil, to Latin America, and for nations. I say thank you for who you are. Thank you for who you are in every single nation. We love you, Jesus.
In this place, for the priests who found Jesus. pray you release your glory over identity, Jesus. Because Jesus, you are the only one who truly knows our identity. And I just pray that you release your glory over the confused, Lord, over the broken, over the lost, Jesus. Let them know that they are truly loved and they have something to live for. I just praise you, Jesus.
Sufferings that are happening to this generation there will not compare to the glory that will be revealed in them, Lord. I thank you, Lord, that the glory is being revealed right now in them, Lord, that they are going to pick up the pieces of war, a war-torn nation, and glory shall be revealed in Gen Z in Ukraine, in Jesus' name.
Again, I ask, Lord, this in your name. Amen. We release the glory.
be in Somalia and that you would be in North Korea, God, and that the unreached would come to know you. God, I'm also asking that you would release your glory into sorority houses and fraternity houses at college campuses, God. I ask that you would bind the brokenhearted from alcoholism, from drug addiction, from eating disorders, God. I pray that your glory would fall, Jesus, and that we would just release that, Lord, in your name. Thank you, God. Amen.
These are some great prayers. Y'all, you know what the hope is? The Bible says the fervent prayers of the righteous, they avail in much. These are good prayers. Come on. Jesus, we release your glory.
God, we just pray for all of Gen Z right now. Holy Spirit, that you would take what's going on here, God, and that you would sweep across our nation over Gen Z, God. God, that you would start a fire with inside Gen Z, God, that you would raise up revivalists. Holy Spirit, that you would pour out your spirit, God, that you are planting vessels of glory and fire within Gen Z, God. God, that out of our bellies, God, would flow rivers of living water, God. You would flow revival fire out of our lives, God. You would turn a generation's heart back to you, God. That you would take our heart of stone and turn it into a heart of flesh again, God. God, that we would be the ones that would ascend the mountain of the Lord with pure hands and a clean heart, God. That we would return to the heart of the Father and begin weeping at your feet again, God, and pouring out our oil, God. That we would come to you, fill our horn with oil, and we would be sent out into the nations.
Father, I just thank you right now that no weapon formed against either will prosper, and every tongue that accuses them in judgment stands condemned. I release the glory there, and I speak life over those two places, and I declare right now in Jesus' name that the gospel will be spread in China and in Taiwan.
Upper room with your presence, grace this nation that is crying out for the Father, Lord, would you come down and rest upon your sons and daughters who call upon your name. In Jesus' name.
I release the glory of the Lord over the woman in this church, over the woman in this nation, that in this hour you release life over this nation, that death does not have an assignment, but it's broken over you in Jesus' name. I declare all Deborahs and Esthers to arise in this moment in Jesus' name. I declare that Upper Room is a company of women that are walking in their authority and their identity and purity in the name of Jesus, that your voices are arising in this moment in Jesus' name. I command all prophetic voices to arise, all intercessors to arise in Jesus' name.
And we release it, God.
Suffering and out of that time of hurt, and that they will be healed right now.
your hands out. We're going to pray for him. When Gen Z prays for Gen Z, we pray for Gen Z too. Jesus, we thank you for this representation of Gen Z, Lord. We thank you. We agree with his prayers that this generation will know the gospel, that this generation will choose you, that this generation will walk in the power of your word, that they'll come and they'll declare that Jesus is Lord. Father, we lift up Gen Z. We declare, Gen Z, we're with you. The glory of the Lord is upon you. He'll rise on you. We call forth those who will proclaim the gospel in Gen Z. We say, let the spirit of power and might and counsel fall on you, Gen Z. We agree. We declare your glory in Gen Z as a royal priesthood in the face and name of Jesus. Let your glory fill Gen Z. Amen.
How much more does he love?
sing.